Hello, and welcome to the Triumphant Church of God Durham broadcast. We are so happy that you've taken the time to join us today, and we pray that you will be blessed by today's service. God is moving in a dynamic way, and we are so excited to hear what our pastor is going to share with us. So I will see you in the sanctuary. May God bless you. Have a wonderful day.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the Triumphant Church of God in Durham, Canada. My name is Pastor Coleman, and this is the Pastor's Corner. Once again, we just give God thanks for another day He has allowed us to see. What a wonderful thing it is to be in the land of the living. We just came out of a wonderful convention, a time of refreshing, a time of encouragement. And first and foremost, I just want to thank each and every one of you who tuned in, who were in person and were a part of what God has done in our during our national convention. Truly, the presence of God was in every service that we had, and we just give Him the highest praise. To Him be the glory. And I just want to say thank you to those of you, not only for your presence, but also for your financial giving, as you sowed into these ministries throughout this convention. God is going to bless you and encourage you in your own personal lives. So thank you again. It was a great success, and it would not have been if it wasn't for your support during that convention. So we're out of convention, but the Spirit of God is with us. And I promised last week that perhaps there would be an update for you that I could share. I want to let you know that God has been tremendously good to us. He has blessed us in the region of Durham, Canada, with a place of worship. It has been a long time coming. We have toiled for 3 long years, and we have searched every which way we could, but God has come through for us and provided us a place of worship. And so we just want to thank God this morning. We just want to praise God, and we will be transitioning in many ways, and you will see from a standpoint of what you will see on our broadcast. Our broadcasts will continue, but they will be in a place of worship. And I just want to say thank God for answering our prayer. Thank God for moving us. And thank God for giving us an opportunity to serve the community in a much more impactful manner. I want to thank all of you who have given and will continue to give toward the work of the Lord. Now that we will be in a physical space of worship, we are counting on your support to do what God wants us to do in this region of Durham. More details will follow, but as of the second Sunday in the month of June, we will be in our building, and we want you to come and be a part of what God has done and what God is doing. We're excited. God is so good, and I can't contain myself. God is so good. Yes, He is so good. So stay tuned. We will have more details to follow, and you're just going to be so blessed. And so we thank God for you. And so as we get into the service on this Sunday morning, this final Sunday in the month of May, we have many things that God has placed in our hearts to do. We just want you to know we love you all, we appreciate you all, and we want to stay humble at the feet of Jesus as we serve the people of God on behalf of Sister Coleman and myself. So God bless you, and as you worship with us today, remember that God is able to do abundantly, exceedingly, more than you can ever ask or even think of. And so let me contain myself this morning as we move into our service. God bless you. May this service be enriching into your heart. God bless you in Jesus' name.
Good morning, saints of God. video is going to have like the longest title ever. Hey guys, it's me again, Douglas, and today we're going to be talking about the Beatitudes some more. Yeah, and the one that we're looking at today is found in Matthew chapter 5, verse 6, and it says, "Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled." Now again, like all of these Beatitudes are talking about, Jesus is talking about people who seem really unfortunate but are actually very blessed. And I don't really know anybody who likes being hungry, right? That's not like a good thing to be. Nobody likes being hungry. In fact, it's a very good thing to help people who are hungry. You know, there are people all over the world who don't have enough to eat, and it's good for us to do what we can to help them to get the food that they need. People who are hungry are usually thought of as being very unfortunate. And Jesus isn't talking here about being hungry for food, although he does say something pretty similar to that in the book of Luke. But he's saying that blessed are you if you are so wanting to be righteous, if you are so wanting to do what is good, that it hurts. It hurts in the same way that it hurts when you're hungry. And that word righteousness, it just means doing what is right. And so if you're hungry and thirsty for righteousness, you are hungry and thirsty for wanting to do the right thing. You know, there was this one time where I was running late for school, so I didn't get to have breakfast, and I was also running so late that I forgot to grab my lunch, and I didn't even have my little card with me. You know, my mom usually sends with me in case I forget my lunch so I can get something from the cafeteria, but I forgot that little card too. So I didn't have any breakfast, and then I didn't have any lunch at school, and then I had soccer practice right after school, and so I was taking the whole day with no food. Now, some people go even more than a day, but for me, even just skipping two meals made me feel uncomfortable. Now, some people, again, are in really, really bad situations where they go days and days without food, but all day I was just thinking, oh, I just want some spaghetti. Just specifically, I wanted spaghetti really bad. And just spaghetti, spaghetti, spaghetti. All day I'm thinking, I want some spaghetti, and my stomach is hurting, and you know, it was really uncomfortable. But when I got home, there was a big old plate of spaghetti waiting for me. And so I'm hungry for spaghetti all day, and then at the end of the day, turns out, that's what I get. I get the spaghetti, and I was so happy, and I ate so much. It was very satisfying. It was very good. Now, the whole day at school, you know, if you could hear my tummy rumbling, or if you knew that I was super hungry, you wouldn't think to yourself, oh, Douglas is super lucky. I want to be just like Douglas. He's so hungry. You might say I was lucky. You might say I was blessed if you knew what was coming, if you knew that I was going to get some spaghetti at the end of the day. But just that feeling of being hungry, that's something that most people, you know, spend a good portion of their day trying to avoid. Now, if you are a Christian, that pretty much means that you want to be like Jesus, right? That's pretty much what a Christian means, someone who is following Christ, someone who is trying to be Christ-like. And man, when I look at the example that Jesus set for us, you know, the way that he loved people who seemed unlovable, the way that he stood up for what was right, the way that he did what he was supposed to do and did not do what he was not supposed to do, man, he is the only one who has never ever sinned. He set an amazing example for us, but that example that he set for us and the call that he has given to each of us to do what is right, that can be kind of intimidating sometimes and even uncomfortable. Because if you say, yeah, I want to do what's right, and then you mess up, that's a really, really uncomfortable feeling. I know I get very embarrassed when I do something that I know is wrong. Maybe not in that second do I feel embarrassed, but as soon as I realize what I did, it's a very uncomfortable feeling. And some people, when they get that uncomfortable feeling, they try to, you know, just explain it away or ignore what they're feeling. You know, ignore that tugging of the Holy Spirit saying that what you did was wrong. And they say, well, I can't be just like Jesus. Jesus is God, right? I can't do what he did. And so maybe it's okay for me to just mess up sometimes, so I'm not even going to try. But I think here when Jesus says, blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. I think that when he says that, he's saying that it's good to feel a little uncomfortable. It's good to feel bad when we do what's wrong. Now, again, I don't think God wants us to just give up and be like, oh, I messed up. I'm the worst ever. No, I think he's saying that when we mess up, we should allow ourselves to feel bad for what we've done and try to do better next time. We're supposed to try so hard that it kind of hurts. You know what I mean? It hurts in the same way that your stomach hurts when you're hungry. And so my challenge to you guys today is that you would hunger and thirst for righteousness. That you would want to do what is right so bad that it kind of hurts a little bit. And that you'll keep trying and keep trying even when you mess up. Because if your goal is to do what is right, if your goal is to be righteous and be like Jesus Christ, if you want that so bad that it hurts, Jesus says that you are blessed because you will achieve your goal. It might not be today. It might not be tomorrow. It might be a long time. But if you hunger and thirst for righteousness, then you will be filled.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the Triumphant Church of God in Durham, Canada. God is good, and He is greatly to be praised. And as I said earlier in our broadcast, I'm excited about what God is doing in the Triumphant Church of God in the region of Durham. God blows our mind constantly. God blows our mind constantly. And if you're thirsty enough for Him, He will give you more than you could ever imagine. And as I said earlier, we are in the midst of transition and we're moving into our physical space of worship, and we're excited about what God is going to do and what He's doing right now. If you remain faithful to Him, He will give you things that you do not even qualify for. And this morning, I just want to share a word with you. It's particular in about being faithful and being thirsty for Him. He is a great, great God. And even when people count you out, when people say, oh, it can't be done, I come to tell you this morning, when you are thirsty for Him, when you are hungry for Him, when you are seeking His face with all your heart, great things happen. We are living witnesses this morning to say, look what the Lord has done. He has done great and mighty things, whereof I am glad, whereof I can rejoice in the God of my salvation. So I want you on this last Sunday of May to rejoice with me as I share this word of God with you. Nobody knows the amount of ups and downs that we have been through to get to this point. Nobody knows what you have been through to get to where you are today. But we rejoice in the God of our salvation. And sometimes we can't contain ourselves when we see what God has done. But we got to hold ourselves together and say, God, thank you. And thank you again. Let us pray this morning. Heavenly Father, we owe you all. Jesus, you always make a way where there seems to be no way at all. Lord, do your work, O God. We thank you in advance for making things come together as you do. We ask you this morning as we share this encouraging word that somebody out there will receive something to keep going on their journey. We give you the highest praise, for you alone are worthy. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Come with me this morning in my excitement into the book of John, the 7th chapter, the 37th and 38th verse. I'm going to share this with you, and I pray that it is a blessing to you. The Bible says in John 7, 37 and 38, in the last day, that great day of the feast, Jesus stood and cried, saying, if any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink. He that believeth on me, as the scripture hath said, out of his belly shall flow rivers of living water. I praise the name of the Lord for his word this morning. Jesus' words directly to you this morning. If you hunger, if you thirst after his righteousness, your soul shall be fed. My question is, are you thirsty this morning? I think and I do a reflective piece on this last Sunday of our journey to get to where we are now. If we weren't constantly hungry and thirsting after Him, we would have given up long time ago and we would have said, oh, you know what? The journey is not worth it. When I think of these last 3 years, saints, and I saw so many things that we passed through, so many obstacles that were placed in our way, but our hunger for God, our thirst for God continued. God sent us more God in heaven to all the way out west and said, oh, go and serve out there before the pandemic began. We didn't understand. We didn't know, but we said, God, we're thirsty for you. We are hungry for you. We are looking to you. You know what you want us to do. And as God took us from Scarborough and sent us to Kitchener to serve, God did some amazing things for us, taught us many lessons, empowered us to serve even better and in much a more impactful manner. And He took us from Kitchener and brought us in the middle of the pandemic to a place where we know and we're familiar, which is in Durham, Canada. And we said, God, whatever you would have us to do, we're going to do. And we serve diligently. We serve faithfully. We serve thirstily because we wanted more. We wanted more. And we continue to seek God's face for more. And as we seek God's face for more, avoiding the distractions, pushing the distractions out of our way, we see God doing exponential things on our behalf, causing little to become much. Why? Because He's in it. And everywhere we have stepped, everywhere we have moved, everywhere we have endeavored to do something, we saw God in it. And the scripture this morning simply says to us, if any man, that means you, me, anyone who is willing, that is thirsty. Are you thirsty this morning? He says, let him come unto me. He didn't say, go and do your own thing. Come unto me and drink. He has the greatest quench of your thirst that you could ever imagine. We see in the stores, there's Gatorade, there's Powerade. There's so many different thirst quenchers that are on the market. But someone know this morning that those thirst quenchers can only last for a certain amount of time. But Jesus stood up in this particular parable and He said, listen, come unto me and drink. Come unto me and drink. And we have seen over the last 3 years that we have had to sit at the feet of Jesus and just learn of Him and drink from Him and allow Him to fulfill our hunger, to quench our thirst time and time again. But one thing God has allowed us to do is never become so in such a place where we feel that we're comfortable at all. No, every time He pushes us forward with new initiatives and something fresh, something refreshing, something new to push the word and push the gospel of Jesus Christ forward. You gotta stay thirsty. Someone says, oh, stay thirsty. Yes, you do. Because once you become just so content where you are, then the desire to do more is completely removed. But the Bible says if any man, anyone, it doesn't matter where you come from, anyone, you have thirst, He said, come and continue to drink of me. Learn of me. Receive from me. And you will see great and mighty things happen. This morning, I'm rejoicing today. The scripture goes on to say, he that believeth on me. First, you have to be thirsty. Thirsty, you have to have a desire for something greater. That's what God placed in our hearts. And that's why we're in the midst of transition. Because something greater, no matter what people try to say to us, we believe God, comes what may, he was going to provide. And he has provided for us. He said, he that believeth on me, as the scripture hath said, out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. Out of your belly, great things are coming. Out of your belly, opportunities are being made. Out of your belly, so many people are coming to know the Lord Jesus Christ because of your belief in him. And our belief in him has been strong over these last 3 years. Yes, we went through some real knock hard things where it could have taken us out, lost loved ones. Oh, some of you know what I'm talking about. Sickness came to try and take us out, but thanks be to God. Discouragement came, left, right, and people came and people left over the 3 years. But thanks be unto our God this morning. The Bible declares, he that believeth on me, as the scripture has said, God gives us a promise and he keeps his word for him. Is there something in your life that you've been desiring of him for a very long time? And you sit there and you say, oh, you know what? He quenched my thirst once and I'm content and sitting here. No, you must remain thirsty. Remain thirsty, because as you remain thirsty, that means you have a desire that is always fresh. I desire to do this. I desire to accomplish this. I desire to make it over here. I desire to make this goal that I have set. There has to be a freshness in your spirit. That even when all things around you are going in the wrong direction, you still stay the course and you still push forward, because you know, the Bible says, he that believeth on me, as the scripture has said, you know the promise will be fulfilled in your lives. So this morning, as you're sitting on your couch, or you're standing watching, or you're walking and you're watching, whatever you're doing this morning, I want to encourage you. Keep the thirst. Keep the hunger for God alive. Keep the thirst. Keep the hunger for God alive. Don't allow it to be quenched and then that's done. No, keep it. You need to keep it going, because once you become so content and you sit back and you say, oh, well, I got what I need. I don't need any more. You always need more of God. You always need more of him, because the more of him you get is the more that you want. And it just like your thirst, the more Powerade, Gatorade, whatever you have, you take, you want more. The more you run on, the more you need. Are you thirsty this morning for him? Are you thirsty for him? Are you thirsty for him? Or are you sitting there thinking to yourself, well, you know, I'm content sitting here. Shake yourself this morning and let that thirst continue to be there. And as he quenches your thirst, thirst again. Thirst for more righteousness. Thirst for more of him. Thirst for more and more and more of you. And you know the funny thing is, he wants to give you more. He wants you to have more. He wants you to experience more greatness in your life. But the only way is when you become hungering and you're thirsting after him. Thirst for him. Thirst for him. this morning. May God bless you. May God allow your thirst for Him to increase, because that's the only way you will be able to do mighty and great exploits for Him, is you continue to thirst after Him. As I said before, God has provided a church for the Triumphant Church of God in Durham. I am excited. I'm overjoyed as we walk into this new destiny that God has purposed for us here at the Triumphant Church of God in Durham. That the road has not been easy, saints. And many have said, you won't be able to accomplish it. But look at God. Not look at Pastor Coleman, not look at Sister Coleman, look at God. Look what God is doing. And so we rejoice. Keep your hunger and thirst after Him, and He will fill it. He will flood it. He will refresh it. He will continue to keep you going. I'm a living witness this morning to say, look what the Lord has done. Look at the great things He has bestowed upon us. We don't deserve it, but we endeavor, saints, to do whatever God called us to keep our thirst going, to keep our hunger for Him going. Some thirsts and some hungers, you need to fill them. But this hunger and thirst after Him, it will never be fulfilled. It will continue to go on. He will touch it up. He will fill it up. But it will keep bubbling up. And that's a good thing. Whereas if you are hungry in the natural, and if you're thirsty in the natural, you need something to hit that and to touch that. But the Bible tells us that when you hunger and thirst after righteousness, yes, your soul will be filled, but it will cause you to thirst and hunger for even more of Him. Somebody say, I need more of God, and I'm going to give Him more of me. Today we give God thanks for each person that has been on this line and has over the 3 years has supported this ministry. We have not failed. God be the glory. He has kept us week by week in every session to be consistent as it comes. And it's only because of Him. Don't get it wrong. There have been times that we become very, very tired and worn and beaten down. But God just continues to push us. Why? Because the love of God constrains us. The love of God continues to help us to serve and serve and serve and serve until He has brought us to this point. And this is a different level of service. This is a different level of thirstiness that He has called us to. And we're excited about what God is doing. So may God bless you on this Sunday morning. We're just excited here. And we hope you're as excited for us and with us. And you will join us. But until next week, may God bless you. And as I pray and I close, I pray for everyone that is in a dry place. That is in a dry place, that God would refresh you and bring you to where He wants you to be. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank You for the excitement of the things of God. People get excited for all sorts of things, but I thank You this morning that the excitement that You have given to us is of You. Lord, bless every endeavor that we put our hands to. I pray for every person that is watching. Lord, that You would touch their hearts. Dear God, that they will have a hunger and thirst after righteousness. And that they will feel that their soul is being fed and encouraged and challenged all at the same time. Lord, save those who are not saved even now that may have tuned in. Lord, let the word just minister to their hearts and let it be life-changing. We thank You for everything You are doing and everything You have done. We give You the highest praise in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. God bless all of you once again. As we wind down our broadcast, we just give God thanks for what He's doing. And we are exceptionally thankful to all of you who tune in week by week. And we look forward to seeing you next week. Until then, God bless you and see you again.
Hello. I hope you enjoyed today's service. The message was on point and impactful. I enjoyed it myself. would like to give you the opportunity to support the ministry. For those of you out there that would love to support what we do and what God is doing in our lives, one of the ways to support the ministry is through our YouTube page by going to the About section and clicking on Tithes and Offering. Another way that you can support is by mailing a check to P.O. Box 41001, Amberley, P.O., Pickering, Ontario, L1V0G3. Or you can also support by sending an e-transfer to ttcogdurham@gmail.com. All this information will be on the screen. Thank you for worshiping with us. We hope to see you next week. God bless you.
God bless one and all of you on this, once again, another opportunity. We thank God for the word that has come before, and we thank God for what God has done. And it's a new year, a year of possibilities. I just wanted to highlight and to remind you of the programs and the scheduled services that we have for you listed. Last year was awesome. This year will be even more greater because we're anticipating God's goodness. So let me start off by saying to you, every morning, every single morning, 7 days a week, we have morning devotion. And we want to encourage you to join us. Sister Coleman and myself facilitate every single morning at 6 a.m. morning devotion on our prayer line. We encourage you to be a part of it. Join us, and the flyers will give you all the details as the program ends, but we want you to just be a part of morning devotion. God has been moving, God has been blessing, God has been changing lives, and we want you to be a part of that. That's morning devotion every morning at 6 a.m. on our conference line. We also want to take this opportunity to welcome you to our Tuesday night and Thursday night prayer and encouragement sessions. There has been such an outpouring of thanksgiving for Tuesday night and Thursday night. We want you to come and join us as well. It is being held at 7:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Join us. And this year, we are going to transition from our conference line for our Tuesday and Thursday night to our Zoom platform. And so we're asking you to join us. For those of you who can't join us and need to learn how to get on the Zoom platform, just let us know and we will assist you with that. Also, on Wednesday nights, we have an awesome program, a Bible study program, our midweek service, and we call it Wednesday Wisdom, where God is allowing us to produce golden nuggets of wisdom in the Word of God as we teach the Word at 8 p.m. every Wednesday evening. We want you to join us as well, and that also will be transitioning to our Zoom platform, which the details will follow on the flyer to advertise that change. But we want you to be a part of what God is doing for us, the Triumphant Church of God in the region of Durham, Canada. God is so good. And so we thank you once again for joining us today for our service. And we trust that you were blessed. We trust that you were encouraged. We trust that every week that you come on, you receive a blessing. And once again, these are our services that are going on throughout our week. And we ask that you just join us and be blessed. Until next week, God bless you in Jesus' name.
Hi, and thank you for joining us today. We pray you are blessed by today's service and hope to see you again soon.
Please subscribe for a notification for our future broadcasts. May God bless you until next week.
Jesus, I need you. I need you now. More than anything or anyone. So don't you forsake me. Jesus, I need you. I need you now. More than anything or anyone.
life threatening to take me. And when you see that I'm failing, please help me, I'm fading, fading away from your love. Send your grace, I need another chance to try. Without your mercy and your love, I know I would die. Keep me holding to your love, 'cause I'm open and waiting for your return. Hear my cry, oh Lord, and attend to my prayer. Are you listening? Can you hear me? Are you out there? Jesus, I need you, I need you now, more than anything or anyone. Don't you forsake me. Jesus, I need you, I need you now, more than anything or anyone. Life's learning to take me. Set on my foot not to be moved, not slide. See so many soldiers fall by the wayside. Me no wonder with them on me one life. See it with place of this from me won't hide. Me no want see it and me one Christ. Your will be done, I know my choice. Make them hear your words, I know my voice. I beg you hear my humble cry. Jesus, I need you now, more than anything or anyone. So don't you forsake me. Jesus, I need you now, more than anything or anyone. Life's threatening to take me. And when you see that I'm failing, please help me, I'm fading, fading away from your love. Send your grace, I need another chance to try. Without your mercy and your love, I know I would die. Keep me holding to your love, 'cause I'm open and waiting for your return. Hear my cry, oh Lord, and attend to my prayer. Are you listening? Can you hear me? Are you out there?